Dear fellow scholars, this is 2-Minute Papers with Károly Zsolnai Fehér. This work is about building an AI vocoder that is able to synthesize believable singing from MIDI and lyrics as inputs. But first, what is a vocoder? It works kinda like this.
A vocoder is an audio processor that is almost unmistakable in its character.
It is used to combine the tonal qualities of one sound source, called a carrier, with the frequency-specific movements of a second signal called a modulator. This allows you to create a computer voice.
Fellow scholars who are fans of Jean-Michel Jarre's music are likely very familiar with this effect. I've put a link to an example song in the video description. Make sure to leave a comment with your favorite songs with vocoders, so I and other fellow scholars can also nerd out on them. And now, about the MIDI and lyrics terms. The lyrics part is a simple text file containing the words that this synthesized voice should sing, and the MIDI is data that describes the pitch, length, and velocity of each sound. With a little simplification, we could say that the score is given as an input, and the algorithm has to output the singing footage. We will talk about the algorithm in a moment, but for now, let's listen to it. Wow! So this is a vocoder. This means that it separates the pitch and timbre components of the voice, therefore the waveforms are not generated directly, which is a key difference from Google DeepMind's WaveNet. This leads to two big advantages. One, the generation times are quite favorable. And by favorable, I guess you're hoping for real time. Well, hold on to your papers because it is not real time, it is 10 to 15 times real time. And two, this way, the algorithm will only need a modest amount of training data to function well. Here you can see the input phonemes that make up the syllables of the lyrics, each typically corresponding to one note. This is then connected to a modified WaveNet architecture that uses 2x1 dilated convolutions. This means that the dilation factor is doubled in each layer, thereby introducing an exponential growth in the receptive field of the model. This helps us keep the parameter count down, which enables training on small datasets. As validation, the mean opinion scores have been recorded. In a previous episode, we discussed that this is a number that describes how a sound sample would pass as genuine human speech or singing. The test showed that this new method is well ahead of the competition, approximately midway between the previous works and the reference singing footage. There are plenty of other tests in the paper, this is just one of many, so make sure to have a look. This is one important stepping stone towards synthesizing singing that is highly usable in digital media and where generation is faster than real time. Creating a MIDI input is a piece of cake with a MIDI master keyboard, or we can even draw the notes by hand in many digital audio workstation programs. After that, writing the lyrics is as simple as it gets and doesn't need any additional software. Tools like this are going to make this process accessible to everyone. Loving it! If you would like to help us create more elaborate videos, please consider supporting us on Patreon. We also support one-time payments through cryptos like Bitcoin, Ethereum, and Litecoin. Everything is available in the video description. Thanks for watching and for your generous support, and I'll see you next time!